Joseph R. Pierce, Petty Officer, First Class, Aviation Electrician's Mate, retired. They sent me to Jacksonville, Florida to become an Aviation Electrician's Mate, whatever that was. And you take a test, they say this is what your potential is, and there I went. Yeah, whatever those tests are, they show what your, I don't know, proclivities, what your talents are, you know. I wanted to be an illustrator draftsman, so they made me, this is so, I ended up in aviation because I wanted to be an illustrator draftsman. They said, well, next best thing is photographer's mate, but you have to go aviation. So I said, what's, I don't know what aviation, okay, give me an aviation guarantee. So I got an aviation guarantee, which probably directed me to become an aviation electrician's mate. Now, had I gone into the fleet and done art, they would have said, this guy should be doing art. Instead, they sent me to that school on electricians. So I didn't know, I knew nothing about electricity. I didn't take chemistry in high school. I took physical science. You know what I mean? It was like, I don't know. So, but they taught me. I mean, you know, their schools are very good. You don't pass unless you know your stuff. And as an instructor at the end, I found that out. Only one student flunked, and she got, I don't know how she got through aviation electrician school, but she didn't know anything. But, you know, they when they come in there, they're apprentices, and they know basics, and you have to teach them the airplane. You have to teach them systems and things. So I did that. It was fun. Being a teacher was pretty much up my alley. I enjoyed that. We started off with the SH-2, I think B, or no, it had to be E because or C because the two engines came with the C. It was an A and a B, then the C had the two engines. They had the extra engine. And that was the engineering feat. They took this engine, and all the stuff that you could tune the engine up was on the outside. Well, the next engine, they took it and put it this way. So now, all of the stuff you have to get at is behind the main gearbox, and it was a treat. Not in a good way. But yeah. They added an engine, and they only had three rotor blades on the back blade, and they added another one. Helicopters shouldn't fly, and they're trying to rip themselves apart, if you've ever seen them, and they have to have an extra wheel to keep them from spinning, you know? So that keeps them like that. And the guy in the cockpit is using every appendage to fly it. So I learned basically the systems, all, you know, from the battery to the light bulbs to the autopilot. They didn't have autopilot, they had automatic stabilization equipment. And just basic maintenance, you know. And also I became a plane captain, so I had to service the airplane. I had to fuel it, and when I got into the squadron, I became a maintenance crewman. They had the operators for the sonar gear, but then they also had a maintenance guy. That was me.